தாமோதர் குண்ட் இன் வராக புராணா. பத்ரிநாத் அண்ட் கேதார்நாத் இன் த ஹிமாலயன் ரேஞ்சஸ் இன் இண்டியா, முக்திநாத் இன் நேபாள் அண்ட் கைலாஷ் மனசரோவர் அக்ராஸ் தி சைனா பார்டர் ஆர் ஆக்சசபிள் டியூரிங் மோஸ்ட் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தி இயர் எக்ஸப்ட் அ ஃபியூ மந்த்ஸ். யாத்ரிகாஸ் விசிட் தீஸ் பிளேசஸ் ஃபார் தியர் சாங்டிட்டி, சர்மவுண்டிங் ஆல் த டிஃபிகல்டீஸ் ஆன் தி வே. பத்ரிநாத், கேதார்நாத் அண்ட் முக்திநாத் ஹேவ் லாட்ஜிங் ஃபெசிலிட்டிஸ் அண்ட் ஃபுட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அவைலபிள் அட் தீஸ் பிளேசஸ். இன் கைலாஷ் டூ இட் இஸ் பாசிபிள் டு ஃபைண்ட் பிளேசஸ் டு ஸ்டே. இன் த ஷ்ரைன்ஸ் அட் தீஸ் பிளேசஸ் சர்க்கமேம்புலேஷன் ஆஃப் த சாங்டம் இஸ் ஃபீசிபிள், வேரஸ் தாமோதர் குண்ட் இஸ் டிவாய்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் த அஃபோர்மென்ஷன்ட் ஃபெசிலிட்டிஸ். இட்ஸ் இன்ஃபேக்ட் இம்பாசிபிள் டு ஸ்டே தேர் ஈவன் ஃபார் அ ஃபியூ அவர்ஸ். பத்ரி, கேதார், கங்கோத்ரி, யமுனோத்ரி அண்ட் முக்திநாத் ஆர் பிளேசஸ் ஃபார் விச் நோ எக்ஸ்ட்ரா ட்ராவல் சார்ஜஸ் நீட் டு பி பெய்ட் அண்ட் வாட் எவர் த ட்ராவல் ஏஜென்ட் டிமாண்ட்ஸ் இன்க்ளூட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ த காஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த மவுண்டன் ஜேர்னி டு தீஸ் பிளேசஸ். ட்ராவல் டு கைலாஷ் மானசரோவர் என்டெயில்ஸ் கெட்டிங் பாஸ்போர்ட் அண்ட் விசா, இன்கரிங் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் தேர் ஃபார். பிசைட்ஸ் தேர் இஸ் அ டோல் பேபிள் ஃபார் என்ட்ரி இன் டு த சைனீஸ் டெரிட்டரி, பட் தர்ஷன் ஆஃப் த தாமோதர் குண்ட் காஸ்ட் மச் மோர். And from the advertisement of travel agents, I could make out that the amount I had paid for my trip to that holy place was much higher than the charges for a Kailash Yatra. Moreover, the poor facilities provided to Yatrikas during that trip was detestable. While Badri and Kedar are visited by a large number, Kailash and Manasarovar are covered only by a handful. The Amodar Kund is actually a tank or pond, but its sanctity is limitless. Sriman Narayana is the creator of the universe, and though the Puranas describe Vaikuntha as being his abode and his being present in the Milky Ocean, it is said that in this sacred region of the Himalayas, his presence can be visualized symbolically in his reclining posture, his omnipresence being, of course, indisputable. Though the Almighty is present everywhere, only some places are identified as his abode, while many others are revered for his divine influence, specially felt at those places. That way, in the symbolic visualization of his posture, Damodar Kund is revered as his head, Muktinath Kshetra as his mouth, the Salagrama Chakra as his chest, the Rurukshetra of Palpa district as the waist, Devgad region as the lower limbs, and Nawal Parasi, the place of the Gajendra Moksha, as his holy feet. Sri Shashi's wonderful pencil sketch of that imagery of Sriman Narayana is furnished in this chapter for the benefit of the readers. On hearing the conversation of the pilot at Jomsom Airport, I felt my body temperature shooting up, even in those cold conditions there. The job of drawing off some quantity of fuel from the helicopter was over soon. It will be explained later why it was done. I asked the pilot whether we would be flying at all to Damodar Kund, and he just nodded his head, and that did not convey anything to me. Let us examine now the Puranic story about Damodar Kund to understand the importance of going to that holy place. What follows is the substance of a conversation between Sri Varaha Swami and Bhudevi, as told in the Varaha Purana. Bhudevi asks Varaha Swami, "I heard about the existence of holy tanks near the, like the Damodar Kund in the Salagrama Kshetra. Please enlighten me of their sanctity, Swami." And what follows is explicatory of that dialogue. Nalakupara and Manigriva were the sons of Kubera. They were bathing in a nearby tank without knowing about the holiness of Damodar Kund. Of course, it was nothing improper, but what was despicable was that they were having their bath bare-bodied in the company of young women. Narada Maharishi came there accidentally at that time, on seeing whom the women scurried for their clothes and covered themselves with their garments. But Kubera's sons were nonchalant about the presence of Narada and continued with their amusement in the water, indirectly slighting the sage. Narada, who was patient for a while, called them at one stage and cursed them, saying, "You both will turn into Arjuna trees. Swami, please pardon us for the wrongdoing and cause our deliverance from such malediction." The duo prayed in penitence after coming to the bank and putting on their clothes. Damodar Kund is the creation of Sriman Narayana, and his presence and divine influence is ever conspicuous in it. Besides, he pervades there in the symbolic Shalagrama Rupa, originating there in tens of thousands of that entity. And in the proximity of such a holy place, if you should be bathing in another tank in the nude with young women, it is blatantly lewd and violative of the Shastric injunctions. Swami, we realize now that it is highly undignified. Please now redeem us from the condemnation, remorseful as we are. I cannot do that, please. Only Damodara can do it. When will that be, Swami? In the Dwapara Yuga, when Sriman Narayana incarnates as Damodara, the curse you have suffered will be negated, said Narada, and left the place after sprinkling the holy water of the nearby Damodar Kund on his head. Kubera's sons were soon metamorphosed into trees in consequence of the malediction they had attracted. And at the arrival of the Dwapara Yuga, they were still standing as trees, stark naked on the eastern side of the palace of Nanda Maharaja, always open to the elements of nature. Yes, trees cannot have anything as cover for them, nor do they require such concealment. Sriman Narayana was born to Devaki but brought up by Yashoda. His leela or sports as Balakrishna. Krishna as a child were countless, and when his childish pranks became uncontrollable, Yashoda tied him to a mortar with a rope to prevent his movement. But Krishna, called as Damodara, dragged the mortar itself from inside the house, and at one stage it got stuck between the two trees. Krishna then pulled it further, and at that moment both Nalakupara and Manigriva got released from the malediction they were subject to and acquired their own form in transformation from the accursed trees they were standing as. Both the delinquents then prayed to the Lord, who was giving darshan to them as Damodara, thanking him for nullifying the ill effect of the curse they had suffered. They also submitted to him as to what they should do next. The Lord responded, saying, "Both of you proceed now to the Shalagrama Kshetra. You are already familiar with the rivers, tanks and the ponds existent there. Among those water sources, there is one for which I have immense fondness. It bears the name Damodar Kund. In that tank, both of you should have your holy bath, conforming to all the Shastraic demands. A bath in the Damodar Kund will remove all your sins. Both your mind and body will get cleansed." The two sons then paid their obeisance to Lord Sriman Narayana, present before them as Damodara, and wended their way towards the Damodar Kund. Soon they located Damodar Kund with the help of the identification pointers enlightened by the Lord, and with great reverence had their holy bath in the tank, which left them feeling like having taken a rebirth. According to the popular belief there, Damodar Kund is called so because the rope known as Damam has been tied to the waist known as Udara, and the Lord worshipped as Damodara for that significance has shown the holy tank, which acquired such identity for the aforementioned reason. Though such explication is current, Damodara is a name by which the Lord was known and worshipped even earlier. The tank was also known by that name as Damodara much before. It may be construed that by the occurrence narrated here, the tank came to be known by a large number, gaining its popularity that way. As prescribed in the Shastras, women are precluded from coming in contact with the Shalagrama. Though Damodar Kund and Gandaki are Lord's creations, and in the Gandaki river, he is ever present in his Shalagrama Rupa, coming as he does from the Damodar Kund, which is the place of origin of the Shalagrama. It should not be reasoned out that Gandaki being feminine as God's creation, why such proscription for women is in vogue. Of course, women are allowed to touch the sacred Shalagrama on the Uttana Dwadashi day every year, the auspicious day on which Damodara entered into wedlock with Tulasi. As seen in parts 5 and 6, Sri Raghavendra Swami will be alive in his Moola Brindavana for 700 years till 2371 AD, and to mark that 700 Mrithika Brindavanas would be coming up. Sriman Narayana would of course be present in his Shalagrama Rupa on all those Brindavanas, and it is for that significance such Brindavanas would be exuding their power till the end of this Kali Yuga. The Shalagrama Rupa that Sriman Narayana is, his darshan should certainly be had at the place of his genesis in that form. It was for this reason to take the readers too with me for such darshan through this writing, that overcoming all the problems that I had to encounter, I was eagerly waiting for the helicopter pilot's positive response at the Jomsom airport.